Hello, I'm Jorge Lorenzo, and you are watching After the Flag from Jerez.
Konnichiwa from the Grand Prix of Japan. This is the Motegi Circuit, and this is After the Flag, of course. You can see in the background the Motegi Circuit, and the town is in that direction. I think Tokyo is, what? Volcanic ash clouds in Spain. Only kidding, this is Jerez, the B-Wing Grand Prix of Spain. Bienvenidos! So we're up at Nieto Peloquí corners, famous corners here at the Jerez Circuit, with of course LCR Honda's Randy Depunier. Just the Red Bull rookies are actually going around the track at the moment. It's great to have a view actually, isn't it, from up here? It's quite a nice view of the circuit, no wonder so many people come.
Yeah, it's very nice. It's one of the best parts of the track, and also for the public.
Yeah, it's always a great atmosphere here in Jerez. Do you enjoy racing at Jerez? Is it a place you enjoy coming to?
Yeah, I like, for me, Jerez is one of the best racing in the world because the atmosphere is incredible. When you arrive here for the in the first lap, is incredible. And last year I had a good memory, that's why I'm impatient to start the practice.
Yeah, of course, you did do well and great in Qatar. It's been, all in all, a decent start to the year, hasn't it, for you?
Yeah, it started well. I did a good race in Qatar, very consistent race. One of my best races in MotoGP, that's why I'm confident. And we have a good bike, good team. I feel good, and that's why I'm confident for this weekend and the season.
And your expectations for the rest of the year? Where do you aim?
I would like to be the first private rider at the end of the year. It will be not so easy, but I think I have the potential, the team too. And also I would like to be able to win my first race, even if it will be very difficult. But anyway, I think my package is the best since my start in MotoGP. That's why I hope this.
Yeah, and there was always Donington last year, so rainy race, who knows? Who knows what can happen? Now, actually, Donington, it's quite interesting because the question for last week's competition was, where was Ben Spies' first race? Do you remember where Ben Spies' first race was as a wild card? Well, I'll tell you now, it was actually Donington, as we were saying there. Now, that was a couple of years ago when he stood in as a wild card rider. That was the correct answer to the competition last week. Your winner is on the screen right now. We've got tons of replies. Lots of people saying Indianapolis or Valencia, but it was Donington. This week, we've got a shirt, an LCR Honda shirt, which Randy's gonna sign for us right now. We've also got a MotoGP 2009-2010 video game, which is signed by Jorge Lorenzo, and two tickets to a Grand Prix of your choice. And the question is with Randy.
How many points I get last year in MotoGP?
So the answers for that are, is it 98, 124 or 106? So how many points did Randy get last year? Of course, remember to send it into afterTheFlag@MotoGP.com, sending your name, your address and where you're from, that kind of thing as well. Let's have a look as well now how Randy got on here in Jerez.
We start with the 1-2-5. It's Tirol leading the way as they go into the stadium section. And a big crash, it's Marc Márquez. That's Marc Márquez down on the very first lap.
Marc Márquez has crashed out from pole position.
Cortese's got a problem, so he's not getting any closer at the moment.
Paul Espargaró now right back to Nico Tirol. He's down. Vázquez is gone.
He was desperate to get back on board. He's got no screen on that, Max. So Rabat goes up into third position.
But who's going to win this race? The Spanish Grand Prix at Jerez, 1.5 laps to go.
Tirol just makes a sign, didn't he, to Espargaró?
Paul Espargaró has got the throttle open and his head down.
And it's going to be Paul Espargaró wins the 125cc Spanish Grand Prix and by over a second to Nico Tirol in second place.
Welcome to Europe, Moto2. down towards the right side corner they come. Who's bravest on the brakes?
Oh, that's Corsi's taking out the race lead out. Oh, we've got a pile up.
We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Race has been stopped. The Moto 2 race here in Jerez has been stopped. Second time round, 17 laps this time. This time, it really counts.
The top is ours through our championship leader, race winner, now leads the way. Oh, big moment for Yuki Tomizawa coming out of the final corner. Big wobble for him. Tony Lea sliding the rear of that Gresini machine. Oh, and he's running wide on exit. Tomizawa having problems coming out, and Elias will reclaim the lead. Elias looks to have it. Elias surely will win this one.
What a day for Tony Elias and the Spanish fans.
Racing is underway.
Danny Pedrosa, who leads, Rossi in second, Hayden in third.
Lorenzo into second place in front of Valentino Rossi. Now then, two laps for Jorge Lorenzo to rule here in a red. Up at turn one. Once again, a little bit close before
here they break
Pedrosa. He's on the right, up the inside comes Jorge Lorenzo. Will he make it snip? Will Pedrosa run it wide? Pedrosa just hangs in there.
Oh, no! They almost touch, they almost touch. Lorenzo very, very tight, just kept his bike in there. Once again, the exit. Oh, and Lorenzo's tried it, but Pedrosa hangs him out to dry.
Here he comes, Jorge Lorenzo. He got on the inside on the brakes. Brakes, who's going to leave it later? No, Danny Pedrosa holds him up, runs it wide. Lorenzo takes the lead.
Brilliant, brilliant ride from Lorenzo. Three riders across the line within a second. That's your podium. Hayden is fourth, Stoner is fifth.
A fabulous battle for MotoGP.
What a breathtaking last couple of laps then here in Jerez. I'm with my co-commentator now, Nick Harris, to go through the race. Well, Nick, we both nearly lost our voices at the end of that one. It was actually quite stale, wasn't it, right till the very last couple of laps?
Yeah, but you always got a feeling something was going to explode, didn't you? Danny Pedrosa, brilliant at the front. First of all, I thought Rossi would catch him, but Lorenzo came from absolutely nowhere. But once he got in the zone, and he said, didn't he, in the press conference afterwards, last two laps, I would crash or win. And I think he got that feeling that was going to happen. But full marks to Pedrosa. He really fought hard to stop him winning the race.
Lorenzo's not looking too comfortable at the beginning of the race. He said something about that as well in the press conference,
yeah,
didn't he?
Yeah, he did. He said it's mechanical, but he thinks it's more mental. Mm. He's got to really work at it. And we watched the slow motion, didn't we, at the start of the race. He made a really poor start. I mean, he's got to work so, so hard to actually get up with the front runners. He did it in Qatar. He's done it here in Spain, but it won't always work like that, and so he's got to improve those starts.
And as you alluded to about Danny Pedrosa there, all the crisis talks from Qatar, they've sort of gone out the window now, haven't they?
Yeah, suddenly, haven't they? But people say he can't scrap, he can't race when it gets a bit rough. He raced really rough in those last 1.5 laps. Two times he stopped Lorenzo taking the lead. When he did take the lead, he did absolutely everything to stop him. I think it's a real turning point for Honda, but particularly for Danny Pedrosa and Le Mans. We'll see if it really sticks.
Rossi should be fit by then as well.
Yeah, he should. I don't think it was a particularly good race for him, but he picked up the points, the shoulder giving him a few problems. He'll be fine at Le Mans. And it's breathtaking, just the thoughts about Le Mans, because there's Nicky Hayden in fourth place, really beginning to get the Ducati on the pace. It's all we wanted from the first two rounds. It's as good as we ever thought it was going to be.
The person who's going to be least happy with those first two rounds is Casey Stoney, though. You have to say he's got to do something quickly now, hasn't he?
He has. I mean, he's never been particularly happy at Jerez. He was very happy here after practice and qualifying. He said he thought Ducati had found something, but Nicky Hayden beat him. He tried desperately hard to beat Nicky Hayden on the line. He won't like that. It's an important couple of races coming up for Casey Stoner as that championship chance is just starting to dwindle away a bit.
Yeah, but the man of the day, of course, was Jorge Lorenzo. Let's hear what he had to say after the race.
One beautiful race of my life. A lot of races I did a bad start. I struggled so much at the beginning. I thought this race was not for me. But in the middle of the race, I started to make 40-0, 39-9. I started to catch Vale. And I thought, now I have to overtake Vale. It was difficult because he braked so late. But I was quite calm and study a little bit him. I overtake. And when I overtake Vale, I said, I don't care if I crash. I just want to win. And I try and I got it. So now I'm the happiest man in this moment. Yeah, Danny start to close some lines before the two last laps. And I just wanted to overtake him. I tried in the last corner, por fuera. He released the brakes and we almost crashed.
He rides very brave, so I just have to congratulate him because I never seen him fighting like today.
So championship standings after two rounds of the MotoGP World Championship. Jorge Lorenzo leads by 4 points from Valentino Rossi. In third place, Dani Pedrosa after his second place today. You can see there as well. Nicky Hayden and Andrea Dovizioso tied for fourth at the moment. Stoner has some catching up to do. So Lorenzo made his path at the dry sack corner here in Jerez today, but he wasn't so dry after the race. Here are some of the best moments from here in Jerez. So it's been a great weekend, as you can see here in Jerez. And I think this after the flag might be a little bit Lorenzo top heavy because it's now time for Ask the Riders. Last week, we asked you to send in your questions for the rider leading the World Championship at the moment, Jorge Lorenzo. If you do have any questions for any riders in all three classes, send them into the Twitter address on the screen at the moment. Also, you can send them into MotoGP.com. Here's Lorenzo with his answers.
One little bike with a push engine that my dad make to me to start. Mexican author Carlos Castaneda. It's the number I have to use from 2009, and you know it's the both personalities I think everybody in the world has. It could be a nice experience, but I think I have a lot of things to do in MotoGP. I think Ben Spies. I wish one Spanish guy could be Márquez or Espargaró. Before was Tony Elias, now Colin Edwards, maybe. My father.
That's all then from After the Flag here in Jerez. We'll be back with you after the French Grand Prix in 3 weeks' time. Don't forget to send your questions in to the riders. I'm going to go and join Jorge Lorenzo for the Fiesta and the Cervezas. Adios.